Hi, this is Larry Mantle. Join me and our Film Week critics March 3rd at the Orpheum Theater in downtown L.A. for our annual Film Week Academy Awards preview. Tickets available now at laist.com/events.
LAist Studios.
Today on the LA Report. The victims of Friday's helicopter crash in the local desert include the head of a big African bank. Despite last week's epic rain, California is still behind on the accumulated snowpack.
The good news, another storm appears to be on the way this week, so we have another shot to catch up.
And the Directors Guild announces its winners, possibly foreshadowing who will win the Best Director Oscar. Good morning. It's Monday, February 12th. I'm Suzanne Whatley, and you're listening to the LA Report from LAist 89.3. We now know who died in Friday night's helicopter crash in the Mojave Desert. LAist's Julia Paskin reports six people were killed when it went down after leaving Palm Springs.
Among the victims is Herbert Wigwe, chief executive of Access Bank, one of Nigeria's largest financial institutions. His wife and son were also killed, along with two pilots and Abimbola Ogunbanjo, the former head of Nigeria's stock exchange. The helicopter was on its way to Boulder City, Nevada. It crashed near the I-15, not far from the Nevada border, just after 10 p.m. 911 calls came in from drivers on the 15. The National Transportation Safety Board is looking for witnesses to aid its investigation. For LAist 89.3, I'm Julia Paskin.
The San Bernardino County Sheriff's Office says crews have recovered the body of a woman who went missing in the Mount Baldy area of the San Gabriel Mountains a week ago. 22-year-old Leifei Wang was reported missing on February 4th after she failed to return from a solo hike as the storm moved in. Yesterday morning, medics were flown to the upper San Antonio Creek Falls area to recover Wang's body. It had been spotted the previous afternoon, but weather conditions prevented them from retrieving it at the time. The Sheriff's Department says the recent snowstorms have made for dangerous conditions on the mountain, and it's warning that people who get into trouble while hiking will have to wait a long time before help is available. As of January, California was behind in terms of snow up in the mountains, which is concerning because as that snow melts, it's a major source of water for the state. So were these recent storms enough to catch us up? LAist science reporter Jacob Margolis has an answer.
Nope. We're at 52% of normal for April 1st, which is the end of our rainy season. So if the snow stopped now, we'd be in very rough shape for the year ahead. On top of that, climate change. Temperatures have been consistently warmer than average, meaning snow melts faster than it would in the past, jeopardizing one of our biggest stores of water. The good news, another storm appears to be on the way this week. So we have another shot to catch up. For LAist 89.3, I'm Jacob Margolis.
You likely know LA's air is cleaner after last week's rain, but do you know why? One big reason is because when rainstorms come through, they throw off the atmospheric layer that keeps smog close to the ground. Ryan Cattell of the National Weather Service says that same phenomenon is also what causes June gloom.
If you're flown out of LAX on a marine layer kind of day and it's all cloudy and foggy and then you don't have to go very far after takeoff when you're in the perfect sun, clear skies, you just see like a blanket of clouds below you.
To read more about the science behind why LA's skies are so clear right now and to see some photos for yourself, go online to laist.com. Coming up, how camels are being recruited in the effort to restore Joshua trees.
This podcast is supported by Breakwater Studios, presenting The Last Repair Shop. From co-directors Ben Proudfoot and Chris Bowers, Los Angeles is one of the largest and last American cities to provide free musical instruments for public school students. This is the story of the downtown warehouse where a dwindling handful of devoted craftspeople keep over 80,000 student instruments in good repair. Oscar-nominated for Best Documentary Short Film, The Last Repair Shop is available for free on YouTube and streaming on Disney Plus and Hulu.
Support for LAist comes from Rancho La Puerta, recently voted a top international destination spot by Travel and Leisure magazine. Rancho La Puerta provides summer wellness retreats for anyone who enjoys hiking, mindfulness, and fitness classes in a garden setting on 4,000 verdant acres of nature preserve. Check into the splendor of summer at Rancho La Puerta. RanchoLaPuerta.com.
Back now to the LA Report. The Directors Guild of America Awards were held over the weekend. They're often considered a predictor of the Academy Awards. LAist's Kevin Tidmarsh has more.
Christopher Nolan won the DGA Awards Feature Film category for Oppenheimer. The movie is nominated for 13 Oscars, the most of any film this year. Meanwhile, Celine Song won the award for first-time theatrical film for Past Lives. That movie is up for 2 Oscars, including Best Picture. Next up in award season, the British Academy Film Awards, better known as BAFTA, on Sunday. Then the SAG Awards next weekend. The Oscars will be held March 10th. For LAist 89.3, I'm Kevin Tidmarsh.
This spring, a group of volunteers will head to the Mojave Desert to put Joshua Tree seedlings into the ground. One of them is Jennifer Lagusker from Sylmar. As usual, she will be bringing some extra help, her camels.
You pack all of this weight on them, and to see them get up with such ease, it's truly incredible. It's like they get in the zone and they walk in a line, and it's like a light switch that turns on when you see them caravanning out in the desert.
The volunteer team has planted 3,500 Joshua trees since 2021 after a wildfire destroyed more than 1 million of the iconic plants in the Mojave. To read more about the restoration efforts and about the camels, go to LAist.com. The Southland is under high atmospheric pressure these days, so today there'll be plenty of sunshine with highs mostly in the 60s. Temperatures will remain near normal through at least midweek, then clouds will increase and temperatures will cool for late week. Thank you for listening to the LA Report. You can read more news at LAist.com or listen live anytime on the LAist app or on the radio at 89.3 FM. The AM edition is hosted and produced by me, Suzanne Whatley, with assistance from producer Tyler Wayne. Our engineer is Federico Garcia Rodriguez. Catherine Mailhouse is the director of content development. LAist's executive editor is Megan Garvey. Original music by Scott Kelly. Check back here at 4 for the PM edition. Listeners like you help make the LA Report possible. Please donate at laist.com/join. And the LA Report is supported by Gordon and Donna Crawford, who believe quality journalism makes Southern California a better place to live.